Hi, this is Rich, WB5YBZ. Thanks so much for watching my videos. We're going to talk about the ICOM IC7300 and the Yaesu FT710 as far as their SWR readings. We're also going to see how both rigs work on auto-tune at a little higher SWR. So let's go on over to the computers. I want to first go to the MFJ 259 and antenna analyzer to see, to see how the SWR actually is, and then we'll compare it to both radios. Thanks for watching. Let's go on over there.
Okay, we're at about 725 to 726, and we have an SWR of 5.0. That's 28725. So let's go over to the radios and see how this is. This is with the MFJ 259B.
Is this frequency in use? Nothing here. WB5YBZ testing. All right, what we're going to do is we're going to go down here and put it on RIDI, or radial tail type, and we're going to scroll this down to 10 watts. Now we're going to look and see what the SWR is. It should be about a 5. I'm thinking 5 would be right in here, because here's 3, SWR, 2.5, 3, so 5 should be right in there. Let's hit transmit and see what happens. It's a little bit above that. Maybe it looks like about a 4. Let's see if we can tune up on this frequency. No. Well, I guess it did. Let's see what the SWR is here. Turn off the tuner. And it shows it's higher on 100 watts. Okay, I'm trying to run the tuner, the automatic antenna, and it just won't load at 100 watts. That's because the SWR's a 5-to-1 ratio. WB5YBZ still testing. Let's go over to the Yaesu FT710. All right, we're on 710. We have the power about 10 watts. Now let's look at the S meter. Let's see what it does here. And it's the tune is on. It's very accurate. It says it's 5, maybe a hair over 5-to-1 on the SWR on the bottom scale here. Let's just crank it up to 100 watts real quick and just see if it's 5-to-1 as well. Still the same reading as 5-to-1, 100 watts. Okay, let's turn it back down to 10 watts. And let's just see if it brings it the SWR down. There's 10 watts. We're gonna hit the tuner now. It says it's tuning. Okay, now we're going to try to hit the transmit button. Well, transmit and sort 1-to-1. It's real good. The ICOM would not tune that on high power. Now let's just go up to 100 watts and see. Let's take the tuner off. We're going to take the tuner off. Still about 5-to-1. Now let's see if the tuner will tune 100 watts at 5-to-1. and it's finished tuning, so let's push the button, see if it works. It's 1-to-1, 1-to-1. So what does that tell you? That tells you that the Ziezu will tune a 5-to-1 SWR where the 7300 will not tune at all on high power. Was that a fun video? It appears that the Ziezu FT710 is a little bit better antenna tuner. With a SWR reading of 5-to-1, the Ziezu FT710 had no problems in tuning the transceiver to 1-to-1. On the 7300, the ICOM IC7300, it would not do it on high power. It did it on 10 watts, but it would not tune the 5-to-1 SWR on 100 watts with the ICOM. So it depends on what you want. If you're going to be using a linear, I would just say go ahead and get an external antenna tuner, simply because you're going to be changing bands, you're wanting to have a low SWR for all the systems, including your linear. So with that, thanks so much for watching. Stay tuned for some more videos.